Now starting for the Chris and Weezy All-Stars, we got Chris Butler! We got that recorded, right? 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 We got that recorded. Yeah, okay, now starting.
Judy, Weezy Wee. Thank you. I saw something on Instagram.
Okay.
somebody at a bowling alley said they found Nelly's bag and it had $300,000 on there. And so I guess whoever found it, I guess gave the bag back to him.
Okay.
And in return, he gave her $100.
It had $300,000 in it. And get what she do? She gave it back.
And what they give?
What they give? Tell them what they give. They gave her $100.
Hey.
So he said that ain't true. He didn't lose no bag.
Hey, doing the right thing.
What?
Hey, who says crime doesn't pay? All
right. Kept that up.
Nah, I don't know. I would have gave him the bag back, but I probably would have expected a little bit more than $100. I was like, hey, man, you got $150 in there? Like, can you give me a full tank of gas and $100?
Yeah, right?
Can I get some tickets to the show or something?
That part.
Are you still performing?
Okay, that all right. Part. That right. Part.
Man.
But he said it wasn't true.
Can I get some tickets to St. Louis? Louisville? Wherever the hell you from?
Right. So have you watched the 85 South comedy show?
I haven't watched, but I do listen to the 85 South comedy show. Man, I love Carlos Miller. I love DC Young Fly or DC Fly.
DC Fly is funny.
Carlos Miller is funny to me. And then they also got Rico Bean on there.
Okay, I don't know those two.
Oh my gosh, Carlos Miller is so funny to me, man. I love Carlos Miller because they all on Wildin' Out too. Yeah. They funny, man. They be doing some funny stuff on that show.
So, I guess Rick Ross was on there. Did you see that episode?
Rosé?
So, he was on the show. They were interviewing him, I guess, like 37 minutes in. You know, they start asking him about his earlier albums. Like,
let me guess how Rick Ross was talking. Hey, man, I love success. Success is the beautifulest thing in the world, man.
Oh, you're pretty good, huh?
Yeah, hey, success, baby.
You're pretty good.
Yeah, man, when I got my lemon pepper wings, man, I throw them joints in my mouth, bro. Hey, man, and it's successful, bro. Yeah, Rick Ross, baby. Yeah, man, I love it. We the team, baby.
That's a good impression. But anyway, he said I gotta use the bathroom.
Oh.
He left and had never came back.
I know Carlos Miller was on him. Say, hey man. So we let him use the bathroom, man, and he never came back.
Yeah, he never
came back. One time, bro. Hey, bro was in there for a minute, man.
Yeah.
Hey, them dudes funny, man. I seen them dudes perform live for a while now. And they do, if you go to a live show, they do stand up in the middle of like intermission.
Uh-huh.
And oh man, them dudes funny, man. Carlos Miller, DC Fly, DC Young Fly. DC, I'm sorry. And then Rico Bean, them dudes funny, man.
Yeah.
Shout out to Justina Valentine too, man. I like Justina Valentine. She funny. Hey, they got a lot of good funny people on that show.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I think I've only seen highlights of it. I don't think I ever watched the show. But
if you ever get a chance to go to the Wildin' Out show, it's actually a lot of fun, man.
Oh, you're talking about the Wildin' Out show.
Yeah, to actually go to a recording. I went to one at the Staples Center, or when it was the Staples Center. Now it's the Crip. But it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Man, I would like to go to one of the
It's fun, man.
Now, I know we talked about Jake Paul before.
Jake Paul!
Okay, so he knocked out this guy named Tyrone Woodley.
Tyrone Woodley, yes.
Yeah, he knocked him out. So did you say that this stuff is fake?
I don't think it's fake. I just think that there's certain clauses that they reach in the contractual agreements that mean that they won't. I don't think that was fake because that was a real knockout. Like, no, they really hitting each other. I don't think boxing isn't fake. Wrestling is scripted. These are entertainers, of course. But you know, it is scripted. I'm not going because I love wrestling. Now boxing. I do believe that there are certain contractual stipulations that are reached there. Now, Jake Paul, I think it's fake. All right? Jake Paul ain't no real champion. Or no real this or whatever. Okay, obviously he's training. You know, he's doing his thing.
Yeah, he's not.
But he ain't fought nobody yet. He keep fighting UFC fighters.
So this is his bucket list.
Okay? I guess.
He got five names.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah.
So I'm going to give you the names of the people that he want to fight.
I mean, people keep talking about Jake Paul, but ain't nobody talking about, didn't he have, like, sexual assault allegations on him? Like, this is white privilege at its very finest, man. Because this dude can get away with anything, but ain't nobody talking about the real conversation. All right?
Yeah.
Hey, whatever, Jake Paul. I don't like Jake Paul personally. And, you know, I know people are like, oh, well, people felt this way about Floyd Mayweather, you know, because they wouldn't beat him. And Floyd Mayweather also had sexual assault allegations on his case as well, and also some domestic violence disputes. But, I mean, Floyd Mayweather did fight top contender fighters, while Jake Paul hasn't fought any. All he fights is UFC fighters.
Man, you done messed up my story. I didn't know he had sexual assault. Case on him.
Before, I mean, I don't know the litigation. You know, even though I work for the courthouse, I don't know those things. Because I don't know if it's in LA. I'm just saying that these are things that the public has forgot about. I think that's white privilege at its very finest.
Okay, now I don't even feel like continuing with the
I don't like Jake Paul. I don't like Jake Paul. It's okay. Tell me what you got to say about Jake Paul. It's cool.
Okay, so, yeah, I didn't know about his case.
No, well, obviously, anyway, they're not talking about it anymore. I don't know if he has some type of gag order on it or, you know, or maybe the case has been dismissed. I'm just saying, remember that this has been something that has gone on. Let's remember that.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I didn't even know anything about it.
Yeah, because I don't know. That case just got dismissed from public view. Let's remember that that is something that this gentleman was facing. I don't know what is the verdict on the allegations or if this case has been dismissed. I would just like to say that this is something that went under the radar. Shout out to Jake Paul. Hey, man, make your money, all right? Make your money. This is America. You are allowed to make your money. But I'd just like to say that it is something. If it tarnishes Floyd Mayweather's career, it should also tarnish Jake Paul's career. I'm just saying, let's be fair for all people in different walks of life as well as skin tone.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, good point.
Yeah. Because Muhammad Ali did not have any of those allegations. Joe Louis did not have any of those allegations, as far as I know. Okay.
Yeah. No. Okay, so here are some people that he wants to fight.
Mm-hmm.
Canelo Alvarez.
He will get mopped.
Floyd Mayweather.
He will get mopped.
Mike Tyson.
Yeah, I heard there was rumor of a fight between him and Mike Tyson.
Tyson Fury.
He will get mopped.
Dana White.
I don't even know if Dana White can fight, but I feel like he still get mopped.
Yeah, you want a Fury. Yeah, Fury is tearing you up.
No, forget Fury. Canelo Alvarez is tearing him up.
Yeah.
Stop. Don't go
and
over.
Tyson.
Don't go over Fury. Canelo Alvarez would mop him up. And he's stupid because Canelo Alvarez is a counterpuncher.
Oh, wow.
Hey, yeah. You know, Canelo Alvarez just won the belt for being the pound-for-pound best boxer in, I don't know if it's super middleweight. It's super middleweight division. Come on now.
And then Mike Tyson.
Canelo?
Mike Tyson, too. So.
Oh, he gonna do nothing against Mike Tyson.
Yeah, exactly. All right? read this.
I mean, shout out. Hey, and again, shout out to Jake Paul. You're doing your thing, man. I know people love to hate you. I'm not saying I hate you. I just like for that not to be mopped under the rug. Let's remember that. If it goes against Floyd Mayweather, it should also go against Jake Paul. That's all I'm saying. Get your money, man. If you want to fight me, let's do it. I'll take a paycheck.
I don't want to fight no more.
I know, baby. I know, but the fight is over.
baby. It's over.
I don't want to fight no
baby,
more.
I love you.
Oh, well, if it's Tommy Hearns, though, that's a great fighter. Tommy Hearns, Hitman?
No, I'm just saying you might look like
he fought. Hold on. Let me go over the episode. He fought Hitman Hearns? You know that's the Hitman, right?
Of course.
Ooh.
But I'm saying if you was to go against Jake Paul, I think that's what you're going to look
like. Hold on, let's go something a little far back. Let's go something a little distant. Okay, was it like when Will Smith, because we're going to stick with comedy, was it like when Will Smith said, I think I could beat Mike Tyson, and Mike Tyson tore him up? Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right. We got the rhythm and blues section right here.
Yeah.
All right.
Rhythm and blues. I was thinking about something. But anyway, never mind. So, in COVID news.
COVID news.
Mom was charged.
A mom.
Yeah, a mom charged. Well, a mother was charged.
Because you thinking our mom got charged with something. I'm like, no, a mom. Okay, our mom didn't get charged with nothing.
After her COVID-positive son was found in a trunk of her car at a testing site because she didn't want to catch COVID, so she put him in the trunk.
Oh.
And then she drove to the...
The way that you announced that, I thought he was dead. No. Found in trunk. I was like, what? You tested positive, you gotta go.
So she's being charged.
Okay.
But I think she probably should have, waited till she got close and then got him out the trunk.
Yeah, so, okay, get out the trunk.
I don't know why she would pull up in the testing site and then have the son.
Why are they looking in her trunk, though? Was he knocking? He's probably knocking. Hey, I'm in here.
I don't know, but if this happened, like 20 years ago or something like that, I don't think people probably would make a big deal out of it.
Oh, no, but...
Because, back in the day, I think people used to put their kids in a trunk, just to go to the drive-in.
There you go dry snitching. There you go dry snitching.
No, like you in the car, right? You in the car, and then when you get close to the drive-in, then you like, hey, kids, get in the trunk.
There you go dry snitching.
And then,
just let those people be.
Once you go inside the drive-in, then, you let them out.
We still do that. But then you go dry snitching. Now people are like, hey, open your trunk for me. Why I got to open the trunk, though? Hold on. Why I got to open the trunk, though?
Hey, I'm just saying years ago.
Hey, you trying to look cool for your friends. And they're like, hey, can you open your trunk for me? Nah, I can't do that. What? Huh? No, I can't do that. You over here dry snitching, man. Now all the drive-through companies that watch our show, which I doubt they watching social media.
Yeah, they don't even have a lot of drive-ins anymore.
They still got them, though.
They're probably like two.
There's more than two.
In Southern California. I mean, back in the day,
there's four alone where we live. There's two in Riverside, and there's two out here. You looking silly right now.
Two out here?
Yeah.
Okay.
City of Industry, you looking silly right now.
City
you industry. Looking so silly.
You sound silly.
You look silly.
Hey, you sounded. Okay, boy. Okay. Okay, thank you for watching the Chris and Weezy Show. Make sure you like the video. Subscribe, hit the notification button. Bye.